kind of thinking of that first Christmas, and you're familiar with songs, the silver bells, and a lot of traditional holiday things, but that reading, 'Twas the Night Before Christmas, just lays out a framework. But as I prayed and said, God, what do you want me to share with the people this year? This is what he gave me. 'Twas the night before Christmas, and throughout Galilee, all the people were traveling because Caesar made a decree. And to Bethlehem they went. It was no easy ride for Joseph and Mary, his pregnant young bride. And when they got there, it was such a long trip that the hotels, they were all booked up. But then they got a tip. A stable for my wife? But she's got to lie down. My Mary's in labor. She's got to lie down. And it was out with the cattle, the sheep, and the straw that the birth of our Savior came. The King, Lord of all. But those shepherds were nestled on the side of a hill. The sheep gathered together. So run-of-the-mill. But then the glory of God and his angel appeared. The shepherds were speechless. They trembled and feared. All glory to God and peace on the earth, came this message of joy announcing Christ's birth. So off to their courses, the stables they flew. The Messiah in a manger, swaddling clothes too. But they found those young parents so humble and mild. Oh, they knew in a moment this was the Christ child. But over in Persia, there rose such a clatter that the Magi were summoned to see what was the matter. And what to their studious eyes should appear but a new star in heaven, so bright and so clear. Over mountains, through deserts, no armies or beasts could hinder the journey of these kings of the east. And they stopped in at Herod's. They shared the good news. We've just seen the star of the King of the Jews. But Satan heard too. And he went right to work. He called a big meeting, then turned with a jerk. And the demons then plotted a sinister plan. We'll kill all the babies. We'll use Herod, our man. But while Joseph was sleeping that long winter snooze, the angel said, "Get up! There's no time to lose." And they got up at once, and to Egypt they fled, where they waited, and they waited till Herod was dead. Well, Jesus grew up. He was a godly young man. Now he was ready to fulfill God's plan. The gospel, God's kingdom, is what Jesus taught. Many a miracle from his hand was wrought. Then came a strange day. It was the Passover feast. Satan used a disciple, that devious piece, beaten and betrayed. There was sorrow, such grief, and those thorns, they encircled Christ's head like a wreath. Mary's precious young baby, the fruit of her womb, lay lifeless and still in a cold, borrowed tomb. But after 3 days, he arose in a flash. He loosed those who were captive, and he tore open the temple sash. And after a few weeks, he proclaimed as he rose out of sight, "Go tell all the nations there's forgiveness tonight. And love one another till I come again. You better be ready. You won't know just when." Well, it's a few days before Christmas. What would he say if that King of Glory were to come back today? Friends, there's no need for the guilt or the strife. The Messiah has come, and he offers eternal life. These days before Christmas, those angels still sing each time that a person makes Jesus their king. He reigns now in heaven from his throne up above, still offering to each of us the gift of his love. Forgiveness and heaven. That's hard to believe, but that's what God promises to those who receive. So trust him, my friends. He'll make your life right. It's the Christmas God longs for. God bless you, and good night.